Hello students, in the chapter equilibrium you already studied about the equilibrium constants and the Lee-Chatelain principle. Okay, now let us continue with the concept of acids, bases and salts. In the acids and bases we are discussing about the different theories and the different concepts which explains about what is an acid, when it acts as a base, all those details. In the salts we will study about the hydrolysis. Okay, so anyhow, in today's class let me discuss more about the acids and bases. Okay, salts anyhow we will take up later. There are three important theories, the three important concepts which explains about acid and base. Okay, students, you all know the fundamentals or the basics of acids. It may be based on the taste, it may be based on the change in the color of the litmus paper, and what we study in detail today based on the pH. Okay, now coming to the concept, that the first concept which explains about the acid is Arrhenius acid. Okay, students, can you give me some examples for acids? Yes, when I ask you example for acid, you can easily say examples like hydrochloric acid, which may be present in our digestive system, and you studied about HCl in the chemistry lab also. Okay, you may say example of vinegar, acetic acid. Okay, so you can give so many examples like this. You heard about the sulfuric acid, which is called as the king of chemicals, phosphoric acid, oxalic acid, lactic acid. Okay, so many examples you can give. The common thing which you look at here in all these acids, what you can see common in all these acids, generally you will say it is a hydrogen. Okay, so the first concept which explains about an acid is it dissociating to give H plus ions when it is added to water. Okay, so try to understand, according to Arrhenius concept, if I write acid as HX, this HX dissociates to give H plus and X minus. Okay, when it is added to water, remember students, the H plus ion which is unstable, so we can write it in another way. That means you can write even the reversibility, depending on some of the acids, it may be reversible or irreversible, you can write. Okay, so suppose if I add HX, the acid, to water, H2O, you must remember the physical states when you represent, you studied in the thermodynamics earlier, we say this HX is aqueous, water is in a liquid form, and when I add it to water, the acid will give H plus, and that H plus taken by H3O, it is taken by H2O, and it will form hydronium ion. So the hydrogen, which is formed as H plus, it will be taken by water, so it forms a H3O plus, and halogen X minus is lost, or it may be any anion or negative ion. Okay, so this H3O plus hydronium ion is in the aqueous form, X minus is also in the aqueous form, HX is also in the aqueous form, and H2 is a liquid. Okay, now just looking at this, you can easily understand what is an acid. Try to understand, friends, from the concept of Arrhenius, Arrhenius theory also we call it as, what is an acid? Acid is a substance which dissociates to give H plus ions when it is added to water. Are you clear? Acid is a substance which dissociates to give H plus ions when it is dissolved in water. Okay, so since H plus ion is unstable, it will combine with H2O forming hydronium ion. Okay, so next definition, you try to understand what is the base. According to Arrhenius concept, what is base then? Base means, suddenly you remember about the caustic soda, sodium hydroxide. Similarly, there are many other hydroxide. You can say potassium hydroxide, you can say calcium hydroxide, you can say barium hydroxide, and many more. There are so many acid example you can list out, so many bases example you can say here. Okay, metal hydroxides will act as a base. Now considering the example for a base, suppose if I write base as MOH, M for metal, OH minus is a hydroxyl ion there. And this metal hydroxide, when it is added to water, means in the aqueous form, okay, that also have to understand here it is aqueous, because when it is added to water, there is a dissociation. MOH on dissociation will give M plus and OH minus. Okay, so metal hydroxides dissociates to give OH minus ions when it is added to water. So now remember students, what is base according to Arrhenius concept? Base is a substance which dissociates to give OH minus ions. What is the name of this? It is hydroxyl ion. Remember students, hydroxyl ions are produced from the base when it is dissolved in water. Okay, so according to Arrhenius theory, base is a substance which dissociates. It will be in the aqueous state only. This is also in the aqueous state. So base is a substance which dissociates to give OH minus ions when it is dissolved in water. Okay, so finally we came to the conclusion. We understood what is acid according to Arrhenius theory, what is base according to Arrhenius theory. Arthagta idya? So let us understand the definition again. What is Arrhenius acid? Acid is a substance which dissociates to give H plus ions when it is dissolved in water. Base is a substance which dissociates to give OH minus ions when it is dissolved in water. Okay, so it may have some limitations. Here itself you will understand it is applicable only in the aqueous media. It is not applicable to other medium, only in the water medium. So the other theories also put forward. It is not explaining for all the acids. Okay, so there may be some acids which do not have hydrogen, still they show acidic property. But remember, the first concept is Arrhenius concept, which is based on the H plus ions and OH minus ions from the substance deciding is it an acid or a base. Okay, yes. Now let me move on to the second one, that is a Bronsted-Lowry concept. Now you will ask, what is this Bronsted-Lowry concept? Can we apply it for the similar acids? Okay, now it is based on its tendency to donate or accept proton. Okay, there are some substances which are capable of donating H plus ion, that is a proton. Okay, there are some substances which are capable of accepting a proton. So remember now, according to Bronsted-Lowry theory, acid is a substance which can donate a proton. We are not talking anything about the aqueous medium now, it is any media. Okay, but if it is capable of donating a proton, it is an acid. Okay, simple. If I say the first statement, second one you can easily tell me. Acid is a substance according to which concept? According to Bronsted-Lowry concept, acid is a substance which can donate a proton. Base is a substance which can accept a proton. Okay, so here comes a concept of conjugate acid base pair. Remember, when you study about the Bronsted-Lowry theory, there comes another important aspect, that is a conjugate acid base pair. Okay, so now you will ask, what is this conjugate acid base pair? Okay, this is a pair of acid and bases which will differ by a proton. Okay, if two compounds, we say the pair of compounds, one is acid and one is a base, if they differ by a proton, what is proton? H plus, then it is called conjugate acid base pair. I'll give a very simple example, you'll understand from that what is this conjugate acid base pair. Let me write one example. HCl, you all know it is hydrochloric acid. So what is the nature of this? It is acid. Now if I add this HCl to H2O, okay, when I add hydrochloric acid to water, everybody know HCl will split into H plus and Cl minus, right? Now HCl is aqueous, water is liquid. Now upon dissociation, if it dissociates to give H plus, it is an acid, no doubt. That H plus will be taken by H2O, and if water takes one proton, it will become H3O plus, that is a hydronium ion. So it is a hydronium ion in the aqueous form. Water is liquid, whereas hydronium ion is a aqueous. Now if H plus is given by this, and what is left out there? It is just a Cl minus. So the other product here is Cl minus, which is in the aqueous state. So when I said this is an acid, okay, if it loses a hydrogen, it will become Cl minus. Now my question to you, Can you guess, students, for HCl, which is an acid, what is the conjugate base? The conjugate base for an acid can be written by removing one proton. So if HCl loses one proton, it will become Cl minus. So the Cl minus will be conjugate base. Are you understanding? So for HCl, the conjugate base will be Cl minus. How it is obtained? By the loss of proton. One hydrogen lost in the form of H plus. So for this acid, this will be a conjugate base. Now, when HCl is an acid, this water acts as a base. This base will accept the proton so that it will become H3O plus. So now for this base, it will be conjugate acid. Okay. So for a base, how can you write a conjugate acid? By adding one H plus. So add one H plus, you are getting conjugate base. You remove one H plus, you will get a conjugate base. Okay. So in the Bronsted-Lowry theory, you have to remember two things. The first thing, what is acid and what is base according to Bronsted-Lowry concepts? Acid is a substance which can donate a proton. Base is a substance which can accept a proton. First thing. Second thing, what is conjugate acid base pair? Okay. Conjugate acid base pair is a pair of acid and bases which will differ by one proton. So for HCl, conjugate base will be Cl minus. For Cl minus, conjugate acid will be HCl. Okay. For water, in this case, conjugate, it is a base, and for this, conjugate acid will be H3O plus. Similar examples we can take. Instead of this, I can take another example. Let me take, instead of HCl, some base like ammonia. Okay. So everybody know NH3, it is a base. Okay. Ammonia is a base. Ammonia in the aqueous medium will take, it is a base. Suppose if I dissolve this ammonia in water, now what will be possible? What will be the reaction expected? If it is a base, now the water acts as an acid. Water is amphoteric. You remember, it is acting as acid as well as a base. Okay. So water with the base, it acts as an acid. Now, this ammonia can accept a proton. Okay. It will accept a proton from water. And if one hydrogen ion from water is taken by NH3, what will be the product? It will be NH4 plus. You heard about ammonium. Okay. NH4 plus. So for this base, it will be a conjugate acid. So ammonium ion is a conjugate acid of ammonia. How it is obtained? By taking one H plus from water. And if one H plus is lost, what is there? Now left out is only OH minus. So it will become OH minus. So remember the physical states here. It is also water is in the liquid form, ammonium is in the aqueous, and OH minus is also in the aqueous form. And now this OH minus becomes a conjugate base. Okay. So OH minus here, it will become conjugate base of water. So for any compound, if it is given, you must know how to write a conjugate acid as well as a base. Okay. To write a conjugate acid, add one H plus. To write a conjugate base, you remove one H plus. It's the simplest way you can remember. You add one H plus, you get a conjugate acid. You remove one H plus, one proton only, then it becomes a conjugate base. So the two examples I told you, one is case of ammonia, okay, and other one is a case of HCl. This I think makes you very clear about what is a conjugate acid base pair. Okay. So what you have to practice after the class, you have to write some acid. Like you write sulfuric acid, H2SO4. I told you the formula, here it is there, sulfuric acid. If it is an acid, what will be the conjugate base of that? You have to remove one H plus. If one H plus is lost from this, it will become HSO4 minus. That will be the conjugate base. HSO4 minus, again if it loses a proton, it will become SO4 2 minus. Okay. So you can write more than one conjugate base also. But for one given compound, you can write only one conjugate acid or base, because it's a concept of pair. Okay. There are some substances which will be amphoteric in nature. Come on now, tell me, for acetic acid, what is the conjugate base? Acetic acid formula CH3COO minus. Okay, sorry. CH3COOH is an acetic acid. Now, if you remove one H plus from that, it will become CH3COO minus and H plus. So, acetate ion CH3COO minus will be conjugate base of acetic acid. Are you clear? So, you can write a conjugate acid base pair easily by just changing one proton. If you add one proton, it becomes a conjugate acid. You remove one H plus, it becomes a conjugate base. Okay, so that's all about the Bronsted-Lowry concept. So in Bronsted-Lowry concept, you are remembering two things: what is acid, what is base, and then about the conjugate acid base pair. And another important thing you have to understand, in the conjugate acid base pair, if the conjugate base is weak, the acid will be strongest. Okay, and vice versa. If a pair of compound, you know, if the conjugate base is weakest, then the acid will be, corresponding acid will be strongest. Okay, so that type of questions may come in the competitive exam. The two ions will be given, which is stronger, which is weaker, comparison depends on, if its conjugate base is weakest, then the acid will be strongest, and vice versa. Okay, yes, so that is about the second concept, the Bronsted-Lowry concept, along with the conjugate acid base pair. Let me move on to the last one, that is Lewis concept of acid and base. Okay, Lewis theory or Lewis concept says, not based on the proton or dissociating to give H plus or OH minus, it is based on the pair of electrons. Lewis dot structure, you studied, you heard before in chemistry only. Okay, so according to Lewis concept, acid is a substance which can accept a pair of electrons. Okay, it is not one electron, it is a pair of electrons. According to Lewis concept, you remember one statement, other one is complementary. According to Lewis concept, acid is a substance which can accept a pair of electrons. Okay, then what is base then? Base is a substance which can donate a pair of electrons. Even when you say about ammonia, ammonia has a lone pair of electrons on the nitrogen here. Okay, it can donate a pair of electrons, so it can also act as a base. So what is Lewis concept? Acid is a substance which can accept a pair of electrons. What is base? Base is a substance which can donate a pair of electrons. Okay, so later on you study about the dissociation constants for acids and bases, even for ionic product of water. As I told you, we are discussing about the salts also. What is salt? What are the different type of salts and how they undergo hydrolysis? How the hydrolysis related to the neutralization? Those details we'll take up in the next class. So today's class, you understood the three concepts: Arrhenius concept, Bronsted-Lowry concept, and Lewis concept of acids and bases. Okay, thank you.